from a philanthropist aspect, what this woman has done is she has left a legacy which is ingrained in her children. And through her children, to the larger community who is just passionately attracted to her children. So you find her being the first supporter of Risale, spiritually, financially. And you find her daughter being the first supporter of Wilaya, financially and morally. She's out there giving a khutbah. She's out there demanding fadak. Demanding fadak for what? Because it supports the wilaya claim. So you see the legacy that she leaves behind. Her daughter is doing the same thing. She gave up all her wealth for the early Muslims who were struggling. And you find her daughter doing the same thing on her wedding night, giving her dress away. And when her father asked her, why did you give your dress away? She said, when my mom used to give away everything, you would tell her that whatever you give is actually stored with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So she actually stored all her wealth with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the akhirah. It wasn't really gone. It was saved in a better place. And that's exactly what I'm doing. So I think this woman has left that kind of legacy behind with her children and for the larger community. And I think one message that we could take away from the aspect of philanthropy is that as mothers, as women, we have a great impact. We have a profound impact on how we translate securities, especially financial securities, in our family. If the woman sort of, you know, loses it and says, oh my God, we're gonna lose our money or something's gonna happen, it somehow just translates into the insecurity of the entire family. And if the woman stands by and says, no, it's okay, we're giving in the way of God, and you know, God is going to reward us in multitudes, it's totally fine, then the entire paradigm of the family shifts. And I do have the daughter of Sayyida Khadija, you know, fasting for 3 days and giving up her bread to the yatim and the miskeen and the asir. And we know that the children, the, you know, the young under 5-year-olds, Imam Hassan, Imam Hussein in Islam, were giving up their bread as well. You do not find any riwayah which tells us that Sayyida Fatima told them, no, sweetheart, you were sick, you were hungry, I'm giving my bread, you don't need to give yours. So you find this encouragement in philanthropy, right? Even from young children, it's okay. You don't find the parents discouraging them. So this is the legacy, I think, that lives on. And that is the jood and sakha that we find in the Ahl Bayt, which I would love to say, and I'm so confident that it stems from Sayyida Khadija, salamu alayha. That is why we pay respects to her, even in Ziyarat Waritha, even when we're doing, you know, our other du'as, we pay respects to her because she's the foundation. A good leader, a good partner, and a good protector. And I think in Sayyida Khadija, the Prophet, and Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam, we have a winning combination.